just maybe we don't want that question.
I've been in South Africa since 2003, and sometimes I have to go to the airport to go other places. One time I was in the Joburg airport, and these people started whispering, and they swore I was somebody on TV, so they came to me and asked me that same question. I said, no, but you look famous. I said, well, I am famous, but not in the circles that you would know. Additional research. wait a second, I better put, yeah, I better change hats. Like Sheppy, that's Sheppy. I'm a revolutionary, a culture revolutionary. In culture, I'm a revolutionary. In the real world, I'm an evolutionary. I believe in evolution. But in culture, I'm a revolutionary. In fact, I'm cited in the book as being a revolutionary, one of only two on the planet.
Wow.
Very good. Since if you're gonna hang with me, we're gonna clap a little bit different. Because we believe in energy. So that's energy. But what I want you to do, instead of doing that, I want you to give the energy out. So we're gonna clap right to give it out. Says Brother Anthony Sloan. That's what I was teaching. Now I'm a student. It says Sir Anthony Sloan. I couldn't get brother. Why? Because they don't have it in their system. They can only call me Mr., Miss., Ms., I don't know, something like that. Professor. But I'm a student, so they can't call me. Actually, on the university campus, they call me Professor. Because like Magalisa Robert Sabukwe, I know, you don't know who he is. Well, find out who he is. Anyway, the point is, they used to call him Professor too. He was an older student. Sometimes they do that when you're older. Anyway, look at that. Brothers, what does that say? Can't read the name? Fine. What does that say? What does that say? Look at that. So we have 1, 2, 3 confirmations. Because I could have just said that and I could have been lying to you. We're the Easter Cape. We do a lot of lying in the Easter Cape. I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. I take that back. Make like I didn't say that. Here's the assignment I want you to do. Oh, look at that! I said I was a cultural revolutionary. It said I'm a cultural revolutionary right there. Wait a second. What does that say?
Anthony J. Sloan, cultural revolutionary.
Whew. I ain't lying. Wait a second. We gotta confirm this. What did that say? We have 2 confirmations. You know, as a journalist, you're supposed to have 2 or more confirmations of whatever you write. Y'all know that. Oh, never mind. Don't get that.
Sloan Warriors. That's a nice.
Okay. Oh, look at that.
Third LiKroti.
You do, let me tell you something. The Anglo root of Anthony is incomparable, no comparison. The Anglo root of Sloan is warrior. And easy close up, Kote means warrior. Likote means the warrior. Now what's the warrior? Warrior is just a warrior. But also remember, but this word, Likote, the warrior, it also can mean the enemy, or the hero, the villain or the hero, I should say, the villain or the hero. But remember, as a warrior, when you're on the battlefield, for the enemy, you're the villain. For your troops, for your comrades, right, you're the hero. So no matter whether you think that person is a villain or a hero, they're always the warrior, all right? Great. Here's your assignment. Now, this guy here, I have what's called, there's a thing called a lineage. You come from someplace. So the history of the warrior or the hero or the villain or the things that influence it, or the things that I respect on the Western side, in other words, North America, Central America, South America, I've listed people alive and dead that influenced me. People like Denmark Vesey, people like John Brown, like Red Cloud, like Mark Twain, so you don't know these names, like A. Philip Randolph, or Mrs. Ruth Jones, that's my grandmother, Marvin Gaye, Orson Welles, Peter Tosh, James Baldwin, Sophia Hinton Holmes, you don't know her, Nina Simone, Barbara Ann Tier, Dick Gregory. What I'm saying to you, here's what I want you to do. Think about it. You know, my list is long because I'm an old man. So my list is longer than yours can ever be right now. Right? So when you go home, as you're doing your other research, I want you to just every once in a while, maybe one day at a time, just think of one person, living or dead, that you know about. I'd rather that person be in, like, Africa. Now, I don't want you to say Bill Gates. You don't know Bill Gates, right? I want you to list somebody that you actually know or you read about. And just write that name down so that when we start next week, you should have this lineage. People that influence you. Now, let me just say there's a trick in this. So if you say, for instance, If you say, for instance, Nelson Mandela. You say Nelson Mandela. Now, what that's going to mean eventually is that you respect Nelson Mandela, you follow what Nelson Mandela did, that's your hero, that's your guy, right? That means that you shouldn't be doing anything that Nelson Mandela wouldn't do. You shouldn't do anything that Nelson Mandela wouldn't do. Now you say, well, wait a second, Nelson Mandela, he waged war, whatever happened. Well, you know, that's true. But for the most part, he's a good guy. So say, for instance, you put your mother down or your father down as one of those people. Well, then again, you wouldn't do anything against your mother and your father. Okay? So that's the assignment. Just write down people that you respect. Just write it down. That'll be a lot of people, 2, 3. You're just going to make a list. That's it. That's all there is to it. Wasn't that easy? Oh, one more thing, but I have not a gift for you, but I have, this is not an assignment, but it's to help you. Remember, you all had a thing. It's to help you. You have something about human rights. When we do our audio dramas, we only have 2 rules. One, no cursing. You cannot curse. And guess what? The words kafir as well as nigger are curses. So you can't say either one of those words. Let me repeat that, because some of y'all been listening to that music and then you think that you ain't cursing. You cannot, through your lips, when it comes towards my ear, I am sensitive. You do not say words that hurt, that don't apply. Let me put a fine point on this. One of the words is the word bitch. You cannot say the word bitch. Say, well, no, I can say the word bitch. No, you can't. You know why? Because bitch means a female dog in heat. Unless you are hanging out with a female dog in heat, and you can't talk to them, you can't know. In fact, that's only once a month anyway, so hey.
Oh my God.
So we have no cursing, and the other thing is you can't say anything against the Constitution of the Republic of South Africa. You can't say anything or do anything against the constitution of the country that we do audio drama in. So if I was in Uganda doing a workshop, I cannot do anything against the constitution of Uganda. You got it? Speaking of the constitution, here's a present. Just for them. So now when you're doing your assignment, when you're doing something with the human rights, something like that, somehow you can back it up in here. So I'm going to leave 4 of these with, wasn't there another person here? Wasn't there another
supervisor or something?
Anyway. So you have to distribute it to who you need to. Who's the big timers here? Okay? No, the people that's in charge, right? Anyway, so hold on to that. No, this is not here, so I'm just trying to say, aren't there like.
My thinking is that you give three to Chelsea or to Anelisa because they are in one school and we have a lot of members there, so they can share it. And then the other two goes to Iviwe, who's at the other school, he's over there. And he can share it with the Mary Waters people both. So there's two schools, so they can share those among
them. Okay. Yeah. Now the thing about these constitutions, it's just a reference book. I'm just going to make a wild assumption, which I shouldn't, that you don't have a copy of the Constitution in your school. I might be wrong. We don't have to worry about the students from Europe or here, because they can always get a copy through the internet. Blah, blah, blah. So hopefully I may or may not see you next week. We'll see what happens if you have a question. You have a question for me?
Do you
want
to have another school changing?
Very good point.
Okay, I only got four.
Yeah.
I didn't know. Ignorance is bliss sometimes, but also ignorance will lead you down a common thing. So that's just a reference. You don't have to, I'm just trying to say, if you want to reference, like, hey, this we talk about the Constitution, well, hey, and that's what you do. Wait, did I hear somebody say Mr. Sloan? Whoa! Breaks! Constitution is nothing but laws, and they can change. Let me give you an example. Uganda has a constitution, and a little bit of years back, they had a good constitution. They had a whole thing. For instance, let me do this one. They had a whole thing about when AIDS was really big. You wouldn't know, but it's about like 20 years ago. AIDS was really big. And they put condoms all around, and they knocked the AIDS thing down. Then some politician went to the United States of North America and hung out with some what they call fundamental Christians. These are these Christians that, well, to put a fine point on it, they're racist. Let me finish. These Christians in the United States, these white, I'm gonna say it because I can say it, these white cracker Christians trained some black African Ugandans in the ways of the Bible.
More or less like the Ku Klux Klan.
Well, yeah, that kind of strike. But they trained them, and these African, black African, whatever they were, Christians, they became politicians and they changed their constitution, so it was against the law to have homosexuality. You know, men boinking men and women doing something to women. They made a law against that. This law was so severe that you could get killed. So one year, it was cool. The next year, you'd be dead if you was seen with another man or a woman. So that's an example of laws or constitutions changing. Right now, our constitution, South African constitution, says whatever it says. There are some people in society that want to change that for whatever reason. If they change it, then the law, then the constitution will change and we'll have to abide by that law. So there's laws, then there's other things happening. That's all. I'm not saying one is right, wrong, or indifferent. I'm just saying laws, everything happens. Now some of you, a few of you, when we first met, somebody had a question. I do a greeting that we do in Dimbaza. That's the research group. And it goes like this, very simple. It's a man, you give the pound, you give the fist, as a man, right? But women, we do like this. It's about energy. All about energy. All about energy. All about energy. Now you might say, wait a second. Suppose I don't know, so suppose I want to change my agenda and be something else. Well, then I'm saying what happens is it really has to do with the biology. In other words, when you was born, you have the male has an XY chromosome, the female has an XX chromosome. And a lot of us say that, well, you know, that's because men are deficient. They're lacking in a little branch there, which for the most part is true. This is a commentary, make like I didn't say it because I don't want anybody to be beating up on me. Now, so that's what we do. That's what we do. It's about energy. Female energy is different than male energy. And to put a fine point, I don't know, y'all might be, I don't want to be too young and to go crazy on this. But women, if you want to put it that way, women sort of what we call engulf. Men penetrate. You understand? Women engulf, men penetrate. So to end this, let's do something that we did in Dimbaza. This is very interesting. There is a film that's coming out. It's called Black Panther. Has anybody heard about this film that's coming out called Black Panther? If you have heard about this film, raise your hand. You haven't heard about this film, Black Panther? Okay. Black Panther comes from the comic books. Okay, it's a comic book. It's called a Marvel comic book called Black Panther. Yes, go ahead.
Oh, I thought you were referring to like a locally made movie. I didn't think you were referring to Marvel comics.
It is. That's what I am referring to. Okay? Now, does anybody know Marvel Comics Black Panther? One. You don't know this. Okay, no problem. Here's the thing about this. It's going to be a very, very important film. It's going to be an important film because the cast and the crew comes from all over the world. There's people from Africa, there's people from the Caribbean, there's people involved, some people from Brazil, there's people from Guyana, people from England, you know, like African descent, but they're England, people from Germany, you know, from Uganda, but Germany, of course, from the United States, all over what's it called, the diaspora in Africa. There's people, for instance, you'll find actor John Connie as well, and his son is in the film. Think about that. John Connie is in this film. And his son is in this film. Now the film, Black Panther, the comic book, comes from this comic book, and they have a mythical country. Mythical means it's not real. Well, maybe. It's a made-up country in Africa. It's called Wakanda. Now the thing that's different about Wakanda is that the way the comic goes is that it was the only African country that never was colonized. If you weren't enslaved, in fact, it was so isolated And the warriors so fierce, they kept people out. And then what happened, they got a precious mineral came to them. The mineral was called vibranium. I wouldn't go deep in this and say, well, think of Congo and Coltan, but I won't get into that right now. So what happens is, when they make this movie, I guarantee there ain't gonna be no cursing, because it's a made up country and you need to have different rules, you know? So you're not gonna hear nigga or kappa in the script, because we have total control over it. It's not by those other forces, not by the colonial forces. You got that? So this is very interesting. So, in honor of that, and nobody knows what the script is like yet, if the film hasn't come out yet, so my group in Dimbaza, we have a Wakanda salute. It goes like this. Women, left hand, lay hand closest to your heart. Women, you say, open hand, Wakanda. Everybody with me? Women only, ready? With your, ready, Wakanda. Women, just try it again. Wakanda, that's women, right? Men, fist. Ready, Wakanda. Ready, men, here we go. Wakanda. Now, men and women together.
Wakanda.
Let's try men and women together. Here we go.
Wakanda.
Now, here's the trick. These are regular citizens of Wakanda. If you are a revolutionary or a warrior, if you're a female warrior, you will say, Wakanda. 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 Women, let's go.
Wakanda.
I can't hear you. Women, let me hear you. Come on. Y'all some weak African women. I can't believe how weak y'all are. How could you be a warrior and like that? How could that possibly be? Oh no, this is not happening. No, I've been hearing about these strong African women. Y'all hear all the time. They got some strong African women. They got some strong African women. I've been hearing that, right? Have you heard that? You ain't heard that? About strong African women? Warriors? Wakanda got some fierce African warriors in it. Men. Ready? Men. You're gonna say, Wakanda. Wakanda. That's the warriors. Now if you're just a regular citizen, say, Wakanda. Okay, women would go, Wakanda. But if you're a warrior woman, you say, Wakanda. Okay, everybody stand up. Men and women together. We ready for this? Men and women together.
Yes.
African men, African women warriors, African men warriors. Whichever one you are, you got your choice. You can say Wakanda, or you can say Wakanda, or you can say Wakanda, or you can say Wakanda. Right? You ready? Here we go. We're gonna do it. Ready? Go.
Wakanda.
One more time.
Wakanda.
One last time.
Wakanda.
That's it.
Thank you very much. Please be reminded. Think about the people that inspire you. Yeah, and write them down. We're simply now going to have lunch, and then if you wouldn't mind, you want to tell people briefly what happened together with the guys like Sibu and Chelsea that were at the production meeting on Wednesday.
Do they maybe want to talk?
Does any of you guys want to update? Do you have any questions? Oh.
I really need to update because I was planning to come, but I got caught up in the one day.
Okay. So there's an update needed. Sibu, do you want to summarize what happened on Wednesday?
Yeah.
Briefly?
Okay, sure.
What's our search finding?
We met Tuesday, Wednesday.
Yes.
Yeah, we met
organize the editorial team. And then we met with his computer guy for his name. So he's one person who's going to be joining us probably this coming week.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then we discussed what came up was the fact that for the show this week's coming edition, we have a theme that we want to focus on people, local people, so we write about local people, be it your neighbor, be it you, any person, anyone that inspires you. I'm sure some of you may have heard that even when we were at JMS, Catherine did mention that we were going to talk about people, but this time we were on point, we were sure, okay, this is what we're going to. And then we looked at what we've been tasked to do. So people checked on homework, what the people did, and what is expected of us this coming weekend. And then, on my side, I was told to go and take pictures of what I've been tasked to do, and so was everyone else on what they've been tasked to do.
Wow. Thank you for that summary. Basically, if you want to add anything to yourself or Catherine or anybody, if you wish, does that help to, yeah? It's a case of coming to the next meeting. As you are well aware, Wednesdays is the writers meet to look at the edition of Theta Ubakali, so we can start to develop a really focused sort of production team that's youth-driven for our weekly publication. We'll be working through that for the next couple of months. All right, so we meet on Wednesdays and Saturdays. The idea is that you're learning the editing side, the sort of, unlike the writing, there's a whole area of work that takes place around design, planning, which you're busy beginning to start working on now. Okay? And then, unless there's any other questions, I just want to say thanks to everybody that arrived today, and to Sishle for organizing this venue for us today. Our club needs to grow beyond 30 members. Yeah? We had 60 people that showed up at the beginning of the year that wanted to sign up. We had at least half of our school individuals that wanted to sign up, but it's a case of working with the schools and doing it slowly and steadily. We also don't want to force people to be involved in the organization. So we have a lot of interest, and now I'm looking at all of us as members of Upstart to consider whether you want to bring in within your circle people that may want to join Upstart. Okay, so you'll get membership forms during the course of the week at school that you can take to some of your friends. Okay? I know for